Good evening, church family. Welcome to our third night of our biannual week of prayer. I trust you are all doing well and you have been blessed by the lockdown lessons provided by Brother Marlon and Brother Sean. Thank you, my brothers. We were really blessed. We thank the Lord for the privilege of technology and that you can be spiritually fed by the faithful preaching of our pastor week after week during the lockdown. Before we continue, let us pray. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be found in your presence. I pray that as I speak, Lord, may the Holy Spirit help me. And I pray that it will glorify your name. I ask all this in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. On behalf of the Roux family, welcome to our home. I am married to my precious wife, Tracy, and together we are blessed to serve as leaders of the church and oversee the senior youth. God has blessed us with three children. The eldest is my son Sky, and my two daughters, Ty and Paige. Tonight, I want to talk about our lockdown lessons learned as a family. It is only appropriate to start off by giving thanks and praise to God for protecting us and sparing us to wake up every morning to live another day. Now, as a couple, it felt as if we were not spending enough time together. And now we are together 24/7. I don't know if that is a praise or a prayer item. No, I'm only joking. Spending more time as a couple allowed us to learn more about each other. We communicated more effectively. We understood each other's needs better. We noticed more caring and loving between us. We had more time to pray together. You know, praying together as a couple is special to us. It's like drinking cold water in a hot desert. It quenches our thirst. It just seems right. We found ourselves being more open and discuss things that we could never talk about if it had not been for lockdown. But if we're honest, things are not always perfect. There were times when we clashed and disagreed about things, but we found ways to compromise, work around and accommodate each other. There were days where we needed some space, some me time, or alone time. We have been blessed to spend so much time with our children. We had deep conversations about life in general and many discussions concerning the Bible. Lockdown has not been easy for our kids. Sky seemed to be content to be at home, while Ty and Paige consistently wanted to leave the house. Paige, my four-year-old daughter, would always say that there are no germs by my cousin's house and that she will wear a mask just to get out of the house. It has been challenging to keep Paige entertained as we both working from home. But we learned that we also need to take time away from work and spend time with her. As a family, we were extremely worried and anxious about the kids going back to school. Sky has been at school for 3 weeks to date, and we can only trust God to protect him, and we are thankful for his protection thus far. From a personal perspective, I initially experienced some anxiety not knowing much about this pandemic. Concern for the well-being of my family, my parents with Demir at home, and of course Janine and Mikhail overseas. There was uncertainty about not having a job and the impact it would have on my family. As the head of the home, you had that pressure on your shoulders and felt responsible to take care of all the needs of my family. However, praise the Lord that we both have our jobs and the lesson learned is to be grateful. Now my heart goes out to everyone who is feeling anxious or depressed during this pandemic. I know many lost jobs and had a cut in salary and even lost loved ones and probably feeling overwhelmed and uncertain, not knowing what to do and where to turn to. Fortunately, there is a cure. There is hope, and we can praise God during these uncertain times. My devotional this evening is found in Psalm 42. Now this psalm helped me through my days when I felt down, and I sincerely hope that it will encourage and help you too. Please take your Bibles and turn with me to Psalm 42. I will only read the first 5 verses. It reads, "As the deer pants for the water brooks, so pants my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my food night and day, while they continually say to me, where is your God? When I remember these things, I pour out my soul within me. For I used to go with a multitude. I went with them in the house of God, with a voice of joy and praise, with a multitude that kept a pilgrim feast. Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise Him for the help of His countenance." Now, Dr. Steve Lawson describes the outline of Psalm 42 as follows. The first causes of depression from verses 1 to 4, the faithful cure for depression, verses 5, the further causes of depression, verses 6 to 10, and then the final cure for depression, verse 11. Now, in the opening verse of the psalm, we notice that the psalmist finds himself in a spiritual drought. He is experiencing emotional dryness. He describes himself as the deer pants for the water. So, my soul for you. He is desperate for God. He is thirsty for the true living God. In verse 2, he asks, "When shall I come and appear before you, God?" This question shows more desperation. He is longing for God's presence. The psalmist suffered from loneliness because of his isolation and absence from public worship at the temple in Jerusalem. Is that not true for us today? We also suffer from the absence of public worship. Just 2 Sundays ago, I led the church service, and as soon as I entered the pulpit, I saw the empty seats. The church was cold, and I could hear my voice echo. That hit me like a ton of bricks. Honestly, I felt a bit sad. I miss our church family. Our public worship, it was not easy. The psalmist says in verse 3, his tears has been his food day and night. He has been mocked by men all day long, asking him, where is your God when you need him? That constant mocking caused him so much sorrow that he could not even eat. Now I'm reminded of all the constant negative news around COVID-19, as well as the false news, which can cause us to feel downhearted. In verse 4, we see the psalmist's mind is drawn to remember the pleasant past. It says, when I remember these things, for I used to go with a multitude to the house of God with a voice of joy and praise. Beloved, it's a good time to remember the worship services we had together every Sunday morning, where we sang the choruses and the great hymns of faith. We sang it together. I still remember Uncle Wilfred and Uncle Calvin and Eugene hitting those high notes, and Florence and Auntie Margie leading those hymns from their pew. Well, wasn't that a wonderful time we had? And I must say, Florence and Ingrid, I miss those amens, my sisters. They kept us going. It's a time to remember all our church departments. Sunday school, junior youth, senior youth, YAG, missing months. 30-something ladies and the men's ministries. So take this time to remember and cherish all the precious moments we had together. And now for the faithful cure for depression in verse 5. It reads, why are you cast down, O my soul? Why are you so disquieted or disturbed within me? The psalmist is now speaking to himself. This question brings him to a place of introspection, and he analyzes his feelings. The psalmist is trying to find the cause of his depression. This self-examination moved the psalmist to command his own soul to put his hope in God. This word hope means to wait patiently and put your trust in God. This is the cure, beloved. We need to override our emotions and put our hope in God. He continues to say, for I shall yet praise him. And where does this praise come from? It comes from knowing that God is our Savior. He is sovereign. He is in control of all our circumstances, both the good and the bad. He's all-knowing and he's all-powerful. In verse 7, the psalmist, who is figuratively thirsty for the water in the brook, suddenly found himself in deep water all around him. Picture one big wave hitting you and the next big wave hitting you again, to the point that you almost drown. It's like he gasps for air, and then the next second, another wave takes his breath away. He continues and says, all your waves and your billows have gone over me. The psalmist understands that God is allowing this, and God is in complete control over the situation and is being done for the psalmist's own good. I think of those that are currently experiencing this very same thing during lockdown. You may be overworked, or you may not have work. You may have no money to pay your bills, And even worse, you may not have food on your table. Whatever your trial is, God will make a way. In verse 8 and 9, the psalmist knew that God's love will never fail him and took comfort in God's love. At night he was comforted by God's love when he sang. The lesson learned is that God is with us night and day. He continued to pray to God and called him the God of my rock. Now I immediately think of a huge rock in the middle of the deep ocean to be the psalmist's lifeline to cling and to keep him from drowning. And then finally, in verse 11, once again, the cure of his depression, which is repeated in verse 5, ultimately putting his hope in God. Dr. Steve Lawson says, to hope means to wait upon God's perfect timing with a confident and strong trust in God about the future. In conclusion, here are some final thoughts to consider. How will we overcome our darkest trials? Where do we place our hope? Do we ask ourselves the questions with the purpose to assess our spiritual condition? Beloved, as believers in Christ, when we feel that there's no hope and we feel like giving up, the answer is loud and clear. Place your hope in God. It's easy to go into a panic mode and find help from everyone else other than God. Some will try to find comfort with man's views and opinions. Others will go on a shopping spree. Some will drown themselves in work and others in their hobbies. These things may ease the pain, but it's not the cure. No one or nothing else can take us out of this depressing moments of life. God alone can rescue us from our darkest days. Church family, I miss you so much. For now, we need to be patient and keep on praising the Lord. I wait in anticipation until we meet again. I love you all. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for our lessons learned during this lockdown and for our study tonight in Psalm 42. We praise you for always being faithful and unchanging. Father, rescue us when we have storms and the waves of life that hit us. Let us put our hope and trust in you. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please spend some time in prayer with your loved ones. You can pray around the topic. And please pray for one another. I thank you.